Ashley Miner. Oh, Ashley Miner.
What
are you doing?
I'm doing.
Yeah?
I'm doing something, that's for damn sure.
Ashley, let me tell you about Metal Gear.
Oh, I long to hear those words.
We're finally doing it, the third Let Me Tell You series. Can't believe this is happening.
This is also a reboot, isn't it?
This is also a reboot. You can find some about, maybe 2 hours worth of me telling Mike Blaze about Metal Gear.
I keep stealing Mike Blaze's shit.
Yeah, well, you know. Hi, Mike, if you're listening or watching. I guess watching is the operative phrase now.
Yeah, this is going to be our first video series.
Yeah, we've entered a whole new dimension.
Did we?
So, yeah. Well, in some respects, yes, but we're looking at a 2D video game screen right now, Ashley.
Yeah, we are.
So, I don't even... I'm just going to start this game up while we talk.
Yeah, tell me what you've done.
So, Metal Gear Solid, I've talked about it a lot on Homestuck and Evangelion.
Yep.
My favorite game series ever. Or at least one of them.
I like that has original and easy.
Yeah. And I wanted to share these games with you because they are kind of weird and kind of impenetrable. But I think that if you come at them at the right angle, they are some of the most genius game design and game writing that has ever been done. And I went back and forth a lot on whether we were going to cover these first two games, Metal Gear and Metal Gear 2. And I ended up deciding that no, we're not going to cover them.
Okay.
And you were very scared when you saw this menu screen come up.
Yeah.
But I wanted to do one episode where we just sort of talked about what you know about Metal Gear going in and just sort of the preamble to it. And I figured, you know, put some kind of video underneath that. Why not just... I'll play Metal Gear 1 while we talk about Metal Gear as a whole.
That's how you got a call.
Metal Gear Solid.
And you didn't answer.
What's that?
That's how you got a call. You didn't answer.
What? You get a lot of calls you don't answer in this game.
Okay.
But yes, yeah, so you are not totally new to Metal Gear.
Punch that guy. Punch that guy.
He gets punched. Yeah. So we should also explain... You're on a several second delay from me because you're watching a stream of me playing this, so there's probably going to be some weirdness where you're yelling at me to do things, for instance, that I did already.
All right, yeah.
Because there's really just no easy solution for
unless
sharing.
We were playing in the same room, which is not possible at the moment, sadly.
Right. But yeah, so you are not totally new to Metal Gear, right?
Yep. I bet that guy's going to get punched.
So, how much do you know, tell me what you know about it, and then I'm going to have some questions, because I think in addition to stuff you've played, you probably have absorbed some stuff just through osmosis.
Yeah, it's almost impossible, one, knowing you, and two,
right.
Just, being, oh shit, that stuff which went down for you.
Yeah, I've only played through this game once.
And also you're talking to me while you're doing it.
Right, yeah. But if I remember it, you played a little bit of Metal Gear Solid 3, right?
Yeah, I played a bit of 3, and I currently own Ground Zeroes, even though I've never played it.
Okay. I think you mentioned you've tried Revengeance also, is that right?
Yeah, I played a few bits of Revengeance, and I did not like it.
Mm-hmm.
And from what I played, like, the first few hours of... of 3, I eventually just, it wasn't a game I wanted to play at that moment.
Mm-hmm, that's fair.
And I think I may have rented it, so I eventually just kept going, just lived my life.
Right.
Here's what I know about Metal Gear Solid.
Okay.
Snake.
Yes.
Main character.
Yes.
He's a spy.
Right, okay, yeah. And you know a lot about spies.
Yeah, I do know a lot about spies. I believe he's for working for the American government.
Yes, yeah.
And he gets called to do. I think this. I don't know if this is. I think this was Big Boss in the opening of this.
I think which was
like
what
in,
do you think
in
is
this
Big Boss?
One. In this one.
This, oh, in Metal that Gear. I'm playing as right now. You mean?
Yeah.
Okay.
I wasn't that what that thing said at the beginning here?
So this is actually I had to load up Metal Gear Solid 3 to start playing this one.
Okay.
Because this was included as like a bonus on MGS3, the first two Metal Gears were.
Okay.
I'm playing a Solid Snake right now.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah.
But also I know the term Big Boss.
Sure. Yep.
I know.
You bought me a toy Big Boss, so that makes sense.
What was that?
Oh no, I guess you bought me a toy Venom Snake, which is yeah. Big Boss.
I know stuff gets weird with names and code names and.
Oh yeah.
I think there's clones at one point.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah.
I think. I know Raiden. I know in the second game, it seems like you're playing as Solid Snake, but you're actually playing as Raiden.
Yep, definitely.
In VR? Question mark.
Okay. Okay.
I know in Metal Gear Solid 3, you are in the past.
Uh-huh.
And there's a lady called the boss.
Okay.
I think she's bad, and then they have a huge, like, speech at the end, which I always quote because I think it's funny because someone once quoted it, like, with Piglet.
I think I probably know the one you're talking about, but go for it.
I don't know. Like, I don't know right off the top of my head.
Okay, is it just where he's getting his code name?
No.
Well, oh, okay, then I don't know.
I also remember that you're now the big boss.
Right, you defeated the boss, now you're big boss. Which...
Which is pretty good.
It's an amazing piece of writing.
Yeah, another really good one is like the whole loyalty for your country, like.
Oh, sure, yeah.
Yeah, loyalty to your country or for me.
Mm-hmm.
They're trying to just remember. Because it's like Homestuck in that I know, I know a lot of like small things about it, but I can't connect them at all.
Right, right.
I think there's a liquid snake.
Okay, okay.
I don't think there's a gas snake, but I'm
there's not
100% sure. Okay.
There's not a gas snake.
I
think there was a time when people were very certain there'd be a gas snake, and then that just didn't happen.
Gas snake, I think, is a bit harder to sell than liquid or solid.
Now, I mean, you say that, but really, when you think about the name Solid Snake...
Yeah, true.
But yeah, they didn't want number one fart boy being a character in the video game. Well, let's move on.
I heard that there's a recurring character that farts a lot.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the thing.
Okay. Go ahead.
And then I've heard some of the controversy with the later games.
Sure, like with the... Yeah.
With, like, Quiet, with, I don't know the character's name, but the one who had a bomb in her.
Right, yeah, that's Poss. We'll learn about her eventually.
Yeah.
Okay.
I heard about Dr. Strangelove.
Yeah, okay.
Just because I'm me?
Right, yeah, and she's, as far as I know, the only lesbian character in the entire thing.
Yeah, and I like even heard that there's some like weirdness around that, too.
She just kind of sucks.
Like,
and you'd
like,
kind of hope that, yeah, it's that kind of thing where that's part of the problem with, like, token characters, is that suddenly they become, like, a statement about how you feel about that group of people, right?
Yeah, like, I was asking, like, does she, like, suck as a character, like, as, or, like, is she badly written, or does she, like, suck in the way, like, a villain would suck or something?
She's not badly written per se. I think the romance story around her is dumb. And it feels very... She's from Peace Walker, which I don't love very much.
Which I don't think we're going to play.
No, we're going to play it.
Okay.
It's not that long, and it's really important to the story of the Phantom Pain, so you kind of can't skip it.
Okay.
Now, we are going to skip Portable Ops, because fuck that game.
but we are going to play Metal Gear Survive.
We'll see. I don't even know if I'm going to buy Metal Gear Survive yet.
I'm surprised I got the name of it right.
Yep, yep, that's the one that they're making now.
That's the zombie one, right?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I mean, basically... is there anything better than, like, having the finale of it, like, after Kojima's left to be, you know, literally zombies?
Yeah. Yeah, there's something fitting about that.
And I've mostly heard a lot about Kojima.
Sure, okay.
And I kind of have known that he is a kind of somewhat of a controversial figure.
He's very,
like, where even where people... But sorry, what was that?
He's very, like... I think he kind of cultivates an image of, like, being an auteur.
Yes, and like with a lot of auteurs...
Yeah.
There are some people who, even people who like him, where, like, you just kind of go, like, yeah, no, that's just him. That's
just him. Yeah, I think he is a very brilliant creator, and also he made a tweet one time about how he ordered two eggs sunny side up, and when he jiggled the plate, it looked like boobs bouncing around on his plate, and he thought it was funny. So, that's, you know, the guy we're dealing with here.
Like, and from what I've heard of Metal Gear, like, it's... I like it when it's ridiculous.
Uh-huh.
I like it when, like, things are, you know, wild and crazy, and... Right. I heard that there's a character called Fat Man, and I'm into that.
Yep, there's definitely a character called Fat Man.
Or, like, you know, Psycho Mantis and all the weird bullshit that happened with him. Mm-hmm. Like, I'm into that, and, like, I'm less into when, like, Kojima goes serious.
Okay. That's reasonable.
But again, I've just heard secondhand information about those things.
Sure, sure.
And
if you haven't noticed, I definitely don't remember anything that you do in the beginning of this game. Because I'm just going back and forth in the same rooms over and over and dying over and over.
I distinctly actually remember I had a book that was... There was a series of books that I used to... My library used to have in, like, middle school that were, like, novelizations of video games.
Okay. All right.
And it had, like, Ocarina of Time and stuff.
Sure.
Like, stuff that, like, made a bit more sense. Like, okay, this has a story and...
Right, yeah.
But also it had, like, stuff that had very much less of a story.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I think Gunstar Heroes was one.
Oh, jeez. Okay.
I forgot, like, there's, like, another one where you, like, drive around and, like, your frog falls down this hole and you, like, go after, like, in a giant, like, jeep kind of thing.
Uh-huh.
Like, I forgot what the name of the actual game is.
Hmm.
I don't think that camera caught you.
Yeah, well, they disagree.
one of them was Metal Gear.
Okay.
And so it almost read as, like, a weird strategy guide of, like, oh, I went into the truck and there was a gun there.
Right, okay, yeah.
Like, and it was not Metal Gear Solid.
It was Metal Gear. It was the game I'm playing right now.
Yes.
Wow, okay. That's interesting. The game I'm showing my terrible skills at right now.
Yes. I can't wait till we get all the comments about you being horrible at Metal Gear.
I am pretty good at the 3D Metal Gears. I make no claims of being good at these old ones. Okay, well, you actually know a lot less about Metal Gear than I was worried you might.
Like, it may be a thing where as we go on, I will...
Right, things will sort of click in place.
I know the big twist of the final Metal Gear game.
Which twist is that?
I guess...
You may as well just say it.
Yeah. Metal Gear 5 spoilers if you care.
Yeah.
Like, the fact that the main dude, and again, I don't know if this is the actual twist.
Okay.
Was actually like, you got face swapped at one point.
Okay.
And you are not Big Boss, you're not Solid Snake or whatever, you are whoever the fuck you were supposedly playing that game, you were actually this other dude.
Right. Okay. That's basically, yes.
Okay.
That's more or less how that game ends.
Okay. Because I heard that, and this was a point where I thought I was never going to play these fucking games.
Right.
And so I was
like, you're still not. You're just watching me play them.
Well, yeah, but like, I was never going to experience these games in any measurable way. Like,
yeah.
I don't even watch, like, the Giant Bomb videos of it.
Sure.
I love the little spin he does when he dies.
Yeah, it's a pretty good little... It's the same thing that, like, Link does in Link to the Past.
Yeah. I just like that at some point someone was like, how do we show this person dying in, like, a 2D sprite format?
Right.
Spin around a bunch. That's what happens when you die.
Yeah. God, I'm so bad at this game.
It may be a case of it where I will remember certain things.
Right, sure. Go ahead.
Oh, you're just getting fucking ganged up on here.
I'm doing horribly. So one thing I wanted to maybe try to do to sort of suss out some of those things that maybe you've heard is just do some, like, word association. If I just say some Metal Gear terms and you tell me what you know or don't know about that word.
Oh, I guess I should say, like, I also, like, the Metal Gear, like, they're these giant, like, nuclear-powered, or not nuclear-powered, but, like, nuclear, or maybe nuclear-powered, I don't fucking know.
Mm.
You know, weapons of mass destruction.
Sure.
That can
yeah.
I think the thing is that they can fire a nuclear missile from a moving, like, position.
Yeah. They're basically anime nuclear submarines.
Okay.
They like do what nuclear submarines do in real life, but they have their mecha because those are cooler.
Yeah.
But yeah, it's like I'm just gonna list off some like Metal Gear jargon. And let me know if you've heard of it, and if you have heard of it, what you know about it, okay?
Okay.
Alright,
you should put a fake one in there, just so I can...
I'll try and slip a fake one in there. Let me think. So we know you... What do you know about Big Boss? Beyond what we've talked about already.
Big Boss in the 60s... He was around during the 60s.
Uh-huh.
I think a clone of him gets made at one point.
Mm-hmm.
I think, I don't think he's around for, like, Metal Gear Solid 1 or 2.
Okay.
I think, like, they talk about him, like, as, like a legend, and then you go back to what happened with him in Metal Gear 3. Metal Gear Solid 3.
Okay. Yeah.
But I think, like, a lot of people talk about Big Boss and, like, multiple, like, both heroes and villains, like, seem to look up to him as, like, a figure of... Like, someone to look up to.
Right. So, I'll show you right now if I can remember how you do this. I can call Big Boss on my radio right now.
Okay.
Yeah, he's my commanding officer in this game. And he just gives you hints about, like, where to go. But they're really bad hints. Because it's a game from the early 80s.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, that all tracks. So what do you know about Solid... You said Solid Snake's a spy working for the American government. Do you know anything else about him?
That's about it.
Okay.
You said Solid Snake?
Yeah.
He's got a bandana.
He does have a bandana, that's true.
He's in, Super Smash Brothers.
Yeah. He was. He's cool in that game.
The thing I like most about him is the codec conversations you can have.
They're really good, and as we'll see, they're pretty accurate to the kind of shit you do in Metal Gear.
I just remember my favorite one being the Luigi one.
The Luigi one is so good.
With the...
speaking of the Luigi one, so do you know what the reference is in the Luigi one?
I know he goes la lu li lo lu lu lu, and I know that that's a thing, but I have no idea what it means.
Okay, good.
Like, I also keep getting it mixed up in my head with Cobra la la la.
Yeah, no, it's la li lu li lo. That's a Metal Gear Solid 2 thing.
Okay.
which is why I'm very excited that you don't know what it is. Let me think. What about Outer Heaven?
I think I remember a little bit of that from, like, the latest game.
Okay.
I'm not sure if it was another thing, though, but, like, it's... Or, like, I've seen people, like, say, like, when Konami... Like, Kojima left Konami, they're like, oh, he's making his own Outer Heaven.
Right, yeah.
I think that was something the big boss did. Like, he made, like, a mercenary group.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And then Guillermo del Toro joined it. And he said, I would die for Konami. I'd die for Kojima. Fuck Konami.
Of course, yeah. All right, what about Outer Haven?
Okay, you see? My dyslexia have an ass probably thought those were the same exact thing.
Oh, that's okay. That's not on you. That's on the fact that there's Outer Heaven and Outer Haven.
Like, are they related? Like, are they, like...
Yes, they are related.
Is this, like, some, like, dollar bin Outer Heaven?
Kinda. That's a thing from Metal Gear Solid 4.
We'll get to that.
What about Foxhound?
I see, like, a lot of people have shirts of that, and, like...
Mm-hmm.
Is that, like, the group that, like, Solid Snake is in?
Yeah. Okay, well, yeah, well... I'm gonna explain the plot of these first two games once we're done with the chat, and we'll get into that stuff. Let me think if there's another good one. So you know Raiden's basic deal. Do you know any like character details about Raiden other than he's not Snake and maybe he's in VR?
Yeah, maybe he's in VR, and then he's also like, well, one I just know like he's definitely like a Bishonen.
Yes, absolutely. He was explicitly made to try to appeal to women.
I know from Revengeance that he eventually becomes like a cyborg ninja. Yep. And he's still kind of ninja in Metal Gear Solid 2, I think.
Mm-hmm.
Or like he at least has a sword.
Right.
But okay. I really don't know much about Raiden.
Okay. What about... You probably know how you beat Psycho Mantis, right?
Yes.
Okay, yeah, that's one of the things everybody knows, whether they've played them or not.
Yeah, you switch the controller input.
Yeah. What about... God damn it. I'm really bad at this video game, Ashley.
It's okay. you're not putting your... Let's just say you're not putting your full... memory into it as you're trying to.
That is true, and yeah.
You knew it was not true, we could say it.
Right, of course. Let me think what else I want to bring up.
I know about Revolver Ocelot.
What do you know about Revolver Ocelot?
I know he shoot gun.
Is that all you know about Revolver Ocelot?
I know that in Metal Gear Solid 3 you run into like a young version of him.
Okay.
And you go, like, hey, kid, it'd be better if you used revolvers.
Yeah, okay. Because
then at that moment, he's just Ocelot.
Right, yes. He's just Ocelot, and then he meets Big Boss and becomes Revolver Ocelot.
Doesn't he meow at some point?
He meows at multiple points.
Great.
That's how he summons his backup. Ocelot's great.
Just Ocelot doing the Ocelot and Big Boss with the, you know, yeah comic.
Yeah. What about The Patriots?
That was going to be a Tom Clancy game, right?
MGS4 is called Guns of the Patriots, which sounds very Tom Clancy.
Yeah, no, I know nothing about the Patriots. I know that is a term in Metal Gear. Know nothing about it.
Okay. Is there any other... What do you know about nanomachines?
I know the quote, nanomachines, son.
Okay, yeah. And someone does say that in Revengeance.
Yeah, I quote that constantly during Tully Spies when they ask how their costumes work.
Okay.
Which they just say, nanomachines, son.
Right.
Like, I know a lot of, like, there's a lot of memes about Metal Gear that are kind
of... Yeah.
I know a lot of people who are very into Metal Gear, not just you, but you especially.
Sure.
And so it is kind of hard to get away from those at some point.
Right, yeah.
It's like, I know a bits about JoJo just because I've seen a bunch of jokes about it.
Sure.
Are you taking, like, screenshots?
That's the binoculars, which you look a screen away.
That's kind of cool and kind of silly.
Yeah. I'm trying to think if there's... Oh, there's a whole other hallway down here. No wonder I couldn't figure out what the fuck I was doing. Trying to think if there's anything else that I want to, like, ask about before I just start going into explanation mode. I don't think so. So let's start getting into this. So, I want to say this game came out in 84? That sounds right to me. I'm gonna go with 84.
And this was made by Kojima still, right?
This was made by Kojima, yeah. He, I think this is his first project at Konami, where they wanted him to make a shooty game. And the problem they were having was the system they were making this for, the MSX, could not process all of that many moving sprites on screen at once. And they were having a hard time figuring out how to make, like, cool action scenes without that many enemies.
Yeah.
And he had the idea of why not make a sneaking game where the enemies are really strong and you have to, like, avoid them.
Mm.
And that's how Metal Gear happened.
Like, was it kind of the first stealth game?
Yes. There's probably a few others that from, like, around the same time where, like, it's hard to say which one exactly, but this one was really influential, and most people would call it the first stealth game.
It's the codifier.
Right. It's the kind of thing where I'm sure we'll get some comment like, well, actually, whatever the fuck, it came out 6 months before this, but it was the first stealth game, for all intents and purposes.
Like, we were just talking about this earlier, like, a lot of people call Dear Esther the first walking simulator.
Yeah.
When they were probably... I hate that term too, but...
It's a term that everyone knows what it means, so yeah. Even though it's kind of shitty, that, you know, whatever. I've got rations. I should use them. So...
I know about rations. Apparently rations are a major thing in this.
If you've ever played Zelda, rations are the exact same thing as fairies.
Yeah.
The
calorie mate.
Yeah, exactly. because MGS3 has a big survival mechanic to it.
You gotta eat those snakes.
Thing. Yeah, you. It's Metal Gear Solid 3 : Snake Eater, and you eat snakes in it. So this game, I think it takes place in the early 90s, I want to say. They usually all take place like 5 years after whenever they came out. Solid Snake is a relatively young soldier. He's been a member of the Green Berets, and he's the newest member of the tactical ops group Foxhound, which is run by Big Boss, who is one of the most legendary, amazingest soldiers ever. Because that's the world we live in. And they have gotten intelligence that there is...
Because his name is Big Boss.
Right. Yawn, I'm sleepy. Okay. Have gotten intelligence that there is a rogue nation in northern South Africa, that it's like a small fortress stronghold that has declared sovereignty and is supposedly being ruled by a legendary mercenary.
That
who
guy
has...
just fell asleep on, like, on his
yeah,
feet.
They're not very good guards.
Also, I just love, yawn, I'm sleepy.
Yeah. Although they changed it for this re-release. In the original version of the game, he says, I feel asleep.
Okay, so I actually know that phrase.
Yeah.
That's
what it's from.
There is a... Of the Mega 64 TV show, There was an episode called I Feel Asleep.
Yeah. And I'm actually realizing part of the reason I keep getting caught is that I don't have the silencer for the pistol yet, so every time I shoot one of these guys, they all jump on me. Because that's one thing about this game and Metal Gear 2 is that they're weirdly... They have a lot of, like, ideas in them that you don't see in games from this era.
Yeah.
Like, I'm trying to think of examples now. Like, there's, in Metal Gear 2, there's a puzzle where you, this puzzle's very stupid because there's a guard guarding the outside of a building that you need to get into. And, how you get past him is you have to go to the, like, genetic lab and steal an owl egg and then hatch the owl egg. And when it starts hooting, he says, "Oh, it must be nighttime. I guess my shift is over." And he leaves the door unattended.
What? That's some adventure game bullshit.
It's some adventure game bullshit. Well, it gets even worse. Because there's two eggs in the lab. One of them has the owl you need. The other one has a snake. And if you pick up the snake, it starts moving around in your inventory and eating all of your edible items. And you have to, like, open up your inventory and catch it and kick it out of your inventory.
Yeah, like, that is really interesting, but, yeah, also, but also really silly.
It's very silly and stupid and obnoxious. But, yeah, no, story-wise, so, yeah, this, Legendary Mercenary has founded this new country called Outer Heaven, and he has announced that he... No, he isn't... Sorry.
Oh, so, okay, so Outer Heaven is a country.
Outer Heaven is a nation state that is... I think they call it a fortress nation. Because it's just this compound.
But
so
they just declare that they are a country now.
Yes, yeah. So Foxhound has sent their number one agent, a guy named Gray Fox, to investigate this place. And he doesn't make it back, but he does get one message back, just two words that say Metal Gear. And Solid Snake, the newest member who's still kind of a rookie, has now been tapped to go in and rescue Gray Fox and complete the mission. So at some point we'll find... Oh, if we kept playing this, I would find him. I think this might actually be him now that I think about it. Nope, this is a random POW. Oh, the Fox I remember that infiltrated this base a few days ago is unharmed. They captured him. Alright, cool. So, your job is to break into Outer Heaven, find Gray Fox, set him free, and then the two of you together have to stop Metal Gear. Oh shit, this thing. As you keep going through this game, like I said, you call Big Boss for hints and clues, and near the end of the game, he suddenly starts lying to you. And he'll, like, there'll be two doors, and he'll say, "Take the left door to proceed," and you walk in, and it's a death trap that instantly kills you. And you eventually find out that he is the legendary mercenary behind Outer Heaven.
Huh.
And it's like, for a... Well, it's basically an NES game. That's pretty neat as, like, an idea.
Yeah.
Like, the hint system just starts fucking with you.
And you could say that that is why he gives horrible hints the entire way through, but it's actually not.
Right, no, it's just badly written hints. It's the same kind of, like, Zelda hint shit. Like, Dodongo's dislike smoke type stuff. I'm trying to think if there's anything else that is, like, super important from this first game. You get to the bottom, you blow up Metal Gear, and you defeat Big Boss in a big fight while the facility is exploding.
Okay, so I wonder what does Metal Gear look like in this art style? Because, like, all I've always seen is, like, the 3D.
So, if you've seen, like, the one that's kind of like a big old chicken.
Uh-huh.
It looks a lot like that one, and it does not actually move around in this game. You, like, go into the hangar where it's being built, and you have to, like, blow it up while the security drones are, like, trying to shoot at you.
Okay.
Because it's not ready yet. But then, like, you blow it up, and then that starts up, like, the whole self-destruct sequence for the whole base, and then Big Boss stops you while you're escaping. You have to fight him to
okay.
the death. And, that, at the time, seems like it's the end of the game. You're done. And then Metal Gear 2 comes around. And Metal Gear 2 is weird. Well, we should probably talk about Snake's Revenge before we even talk about that. Because... I don't actually know what happens in Snake's Revenge, but Metal Gear came out. It was super popular. It got ported to the NES, got really popular in America, and Konami decided to make a sequel to it called Snake's Revenge, where it turns out Big Boss didn't actually die and you have to go stop him all over again, that sort of thing.
Very second game on an NES.
Exactly. And it was relatively popular. Like, it was fine, but it's not considered canon, and Kojima didn't even know it existed until, like, months after it came out, and he was fine with it. He didn't care, but it inspired him to try and make an actual sequel to Metal Gear. So he made Metal Gear 2, and the plot of that game is that there is a new rogue nation state that has kidnapped a scientist who has invented an algae that basically shits petroleum. So he's, like, solved the world's energy crisis. And I'm trying to remember all the stupid details of Metal Gear 2, because Metal Gear 2, even though it doesn't look that much better than this game, is where he starts getting, like, kind of involved with the stories. Like, they get a little more complex.
Yeah.
Like, you spend a lot of time in Metal Gear 2 hanging out with this woman who's, like, a KGB spy that used to be an Olympic figure skater. And she has this whole tragic backstory about that, and it's a bunch of shit. But you eventually find out that Gray Fox, the guy you rescue in this game who helps you out, has also become a traitor and is working with Big Boss, who did not actually die.
Ain't that the way?
Ain't that the way? So you have to fight your way through Zanzibar Land, is the name of that place.
Okay. Sure.
What's wrong?
No, it's fine, it's fine.
So you fight your way through Zanzibar Land, you fight a bunch of dumb bosses, you have to use, like, a Morse code guide in the instruction manual. It's all this big production.
Yeah, I know, like, one of them has, like, you had to look in the manual for the, like, code.
Yeah, Metal Gear 2 and Metal Gear Solid both have things like that.
How do they, like, I know they've done, like, re-releases.
Yeah.
How do they do that in that?
So anytime they've released a... So in Metal Gear Solid, and we'll get to it, because it's relatively early in that game, but basically it's you have to look at a screenshot on the back of the box to figure out what you need to do.
Uh-huh.
And so anytime they've released a hard copy of it or any kind of Metal Gear Solid collection, they've had to put that screenshot on the box. Once they started doing, like, emulated versions on the PS3 and stuff, they just include it in the instruction manual. But, I always enjoyed that they were completely locked into having to always have that same screenshot of you talking on the radio.
Because I remember, like, hearing that, like, I'm like, that's an interesting way to do that.
Yeah, yeah. But yeah, so you get through Zanzibar Land, and you end up having to destroy a new Metal Gear called Metal Gear D. And that one you actually do have a boss fight with, and it kind of just walks back and forth and shoots at you.
Yeah.
And then Gray Fox stops you, and you have to fight him without any of your weapons in a minefield and just fist fight him. And it's pretty cool.
Yeah, that sounds pretty good.
Yeah. And at some point, you start to get the, like, Solid Snake had retired after this game. Damn it, I don't want the binoculars. Let's take them off. But he came out of retirement to fight Big Boss one more time.
Yeah, because he's been having one last job.
Yeah, he's been having, like, PTSD from Outer Heaven the whole time because, like, his commanding officer, like, his mentor, turned out to, like, betray him and was, like, his enemy all along.
Yeah.
And, so he came to Zanzibar Land to try and end the nightmares.
It's good and, we can laugh at this man's PTSD.
But, Big Boss explains that his whole philosophy is that as a young soldier, he felt like he was exploited and abused by his government. So he is creating a new country and a new world order where soldiers are, like, have all the power. So he's trying to create a like world of constant warfare, so that
he's trying to create a new world order, brother.
Yeah, exactly. He's trying to create a world that's in perpetual warfare, so that soldiers are always needed and always have to be
respected.
Respected and like, you know, there's a lot of like Metal Gear Solid 3's ending has a lot of like echoes of like how Vietnam vets were treated. I think that's kind of what he was going for with that stuff.
Okay.
Or at the very least, when he was writing Big Boss originally, that's the kind of thing he had in mind.
But then it gets weird, because of course it does.
So, Big Boss explains his whole, like, evil plan in Metal Gear 2, which is that he is creating all these battlefields around the world, and then all the children of the people that get killed in the war, he takes in and raises as child soldiers, so that then they'll go out and become soldiers and create more war orphans, and he can keep that going forever. And you kill him because that's horrible.
Yeah, that's horrifying.
You've lost all your weapons at that point. Gray Fox stole them from you, so you have to run away from him and find a lighter and a can of hairspray and burn him to death.
Like, and also, like, that's a very action movie ending.
Yeah, totally.
Spice.
So, after all that's taken care of, Solid Snake decides that he has finally gotten past the things that have haunted him since Outer Heaven, and that he can finally retire in peace. And he does, and that's how Metal Gear 2 ends, with the world safe, finally. But then there's like a million more games after that, so you know that's not where it ends.
Yeah.
And we'll get into it, because we're about ready to start Metal Gear Solid here, but basically, Metal Gear Solid retcons in that during that conversation, Big Boss revealed that he's actually Solid Snake's father.
Okay.
Like a fucking Darth Vader type thing. That does not happen in the actual game, but they pretend like it did.
Yeah, you just make pretend like it did.
Right. Well, Metal Gear 2 never came out in America until years later, and it, I don't know if it was super popular in Japan. Like, it was something where they could kind of have some wiggle room with it.
Yeah, it was not like a thing where, and also like people like hadn't like fucking put all the endings on YouTube.
Right, exactly. And the writing is so weird and slipshod that you can kind of get away with saying, oh yeah, by the way, they also said this thing.
You just don't remember it.
Right, exactly. How do I get past this camera? Here we go. So yeah, at that point, Snake feels all messed up inside about the fact that he killed Gray Fox, who was like his best friend, and also he killed Big Boss, who was his former mentor, and then he learns is actually his father. So he retires to Alaska, where he becomes a dog musher, and he stays there for about 10 years until he gets called in for one last job, and that's where Metal Gear Solid kicks off.
Okay, so he's already kind of like an old man at that point.
He's in like his late 30s in Metal Gear Solid, if I remember right.
Okay.
Yeah.
I love that you just have a personal pilotable missile in this game.
Yeah, you know.
And so, like, not like a
I'm basically going to go till I get killed, and then I'm going to switch over to Metal Gear Solid, because we've covered all the background we need to cover.
Okay, should this just be an episode?
I think this should probably just be an episode, yeah.
Should we stop the recording, or?
Yeah, because I don't know how. Oh, you need the fucking, like, flak jacket or something up here. Yeah, let's just stop it here. We'll see you next time when we do Metal Gear Solid, everybody.
Woo!
Don't write in about the things I got wrong while I was glossing over the plot of these two double games.